Hey. So we are live, and today we are going to find out all about Joel Felsenstein and his exciting RockstarX. So, Joel, this has been something that we've been talking about quite a bit over the last few months. We've had trips, we've had lives, we've had all kinds of things happening over the last few months. So I'm very excited to find out today and really talk about the kind of passion project that you have that is RockstarX. So welcome to the show, and give us a bit of an intro and tell us what RockstarX, firstly, what RockstarX is, and then we'll get into a bit more detail. But over to you, Joel.
Well, thank you, Mac. As the strap line suggests, and the mission statement also suggests, RockstarX is for is the place where everywhere creativity and uniqueness meet imagination. And I was quite shocked that I came up with such a brilliant line, and I came up with that like around 2 a.m. in the morning.
and how did you, I mean, like 2 a.m. in the morning, firstly, don't you sleep? Secondly, what was the, how did that kind of come to mind? What was the main kind of vision for you that brought about?
Well, yeah, first of all, Mac, I do sleep. It just so happens that I was doing everything, everything leading up to this week. I could do while doing the business plan in stupid hours, in the morning, all around the clock, and all that stuff, and frustrated when I worked 12 hours straight, and I thought, okay, it's got to be finished now. No, it wasn't. I'm like, Jesus Christ. But the tagline actually came about. I was telling Sam about this, Sam Baston, and it came about when I thought that even though Jeremy Corbyn was not the right,
we're getting political,
really, he had the right idea. Unfortunately, he was the wrong person to deal with it. When he was on the right path when he said for the many and not few, and in a sense, and not a blunt sense like that, I built RockstarX for indeed the many and the few, not the few and the few, because there are so few of us in the world, and we're all unique and creative in our own ways. So that's where the strap line came, and also because I'm a musician and creative myself, it is where those two things, creativity and uniqueness, do come together, and when they do, you've got something amazing.
Absolutely. Well, I'm finding out as we evolve with our conversations, both online and offline, you've got many, many talents indeed. Not only with your technical talents, but also with regards to obviously the music side of things as well, with regards to the drumming and the guitaring, as well as a hell of a talent for putting a killer playlist together, I must say. If you're watching this and you haven't found out or heard about the killer playlist that Joel's put together, that is extremely uplifting and empowering, please reach out, comment below, And we'll get Joel to come back afterwards and respond with a link to the playlist. So Joel, tell us a little bit about, you know, RockstarX, the kind of vision behind what brought it about, you know, why RockstarX?
Well, the vision behind the company, Mac, was brought about by my unfortunate timing to be let go from my previous company in 2019. Got back from the annual trip in California, was basically promised the world what is known as the carrot dangling technique, and of course it didn't happen. But then I got back from California, went off to Israel, and then I got WhatsApp from my boss saying, when you get back, we need to chat. I thought, okay. Either I'm getting a raise, or in the words of Michael Jackson, this is it.
So,
and yeah, it came from that, because no one should be made to feel, if you're on the spectrum and you see a text like that, you'll have anxiety you won't enjoy anything while you're, whatever you're doing, until you've seen that, and then you won't enjoy it afterwards anyway. So I made RockstarX be where you can enjoy, and be the person you want to be and can be. And there is an old saying which I actually tell my students constantly. They said, I want to be the next Jimmy Page. Or hold on a minute. Why don't you focus on becoming the first you?
Wow. I'm sorry, but that was like a bomb. I hope people will rewind and listen to what you just said there, because gee whiz, that is so powerful. Wow. Carry on, Joel. That is such a powerful statement.
And I teach a brother and sister. There's obviously a sibling rivalry going on there. Now they're both learning the same song as well, which is Zombie by the Cranberries. And the oldest one, the sister doesn't really care about the rivalry, but a brother wants to always get one up on his older sister. He said to me, I want to be better than my sister. I said, no. You want to be better than the drummer you were yesterday. You don't want to be better than your sister. You want to be, the only people you want to be in competition are you, yourself, and you.
I've got to share a comment. Wow, hold on. So Don has just gone and said that he's tattooing that on his kids this afternoon. Don, I think I might, I don't know if my wife will let me do that, but it is so powerful.
It's also extremely unhealthy. I mean, who wants to play the game of life and make it into a competition? I mean, what a waste of time that is.
And it's interesting that you say that, because, you know, in life, everything seems to be a competition. You know, when you look at football teams or sports, as a whole, when you look at, you know, businesses competing with each other. But where the magic happens is, and this opens like a can of worms for me, actually, because where the magic happens is in that uniqueness, you know, for each one of us. And I think, you know, you've just opened a massive, like, not necessarily a can of worms, but an interesting conversation from a global perspective when it comes to, you know, if you just look at like the subject of peace as an example, and you know, everything is a competition across the globe. And when you look at just trying to be the best version of yourself, you know, how incredible the world would be if that was each one of our focus, and not being focused on what other people are doing and, you know, the lack of, as an example. And I know, you know, Joseph, who's watching, you know, mentioned, you know, the, you know, having the abundance mindset is one of the things that's so important. And, you know, that message that you just put, just mentioned there about just being a better drummer than the drummer you were the day, you know, yesterday, that those little incremental changes. There's a book, which, you know, it's called The Atomic Habits. I don't know if you've read it, but it talks about those 1% changes. And, oh, you know, I'm just thinking about if the world was focused on those individuals, what magic could happen? I mean, what's running through your head right now, Joel?
I'm thinking that the world does, they like two things in the world. I've seen society do, and I've seen it through the recent high profile court case as well going on in America. I'm not bringing that up, but I'm not bringing up names, but again, with that, it's, you're playing against, it's like you are playing against your parents against each other, essentially. You're either team someone else or team someone else, and if you're nothing, if you're not, then you're living under a rock. This is what society has. This is what society has actually become, and it's quite sad, really, because if you start doing that, this kind of thing, and comparing yourself to others and being on team, whatever, you're going to eventually get upstairs to the big guy, and or downstairs, depending on what path you take, and he's going to say to you, he's not going to say to you, have you given it your all? Have you been the best? Have you managed to topple your rival? No, he's going to say, have you done your purpose?
Yeah, being the best version of yourself. Yeah. You know, doing your purpose. And I think, you know, it's I think back to, you know, when I was a toddler, and people, you know, ask those questions about what are you going to be when you grow up, and I remember having that question in my 20s and then in my 30s again, and I'm like, well, you know, life is got abundant opportunities, and why do I have to stick to just one thing? And you know, I don't really want to grow up to be grumpy and just, you know, compete with other people, because you've opened up an interesting subject here, because, you know, a lot of people associate themselves with what they do, and with maybe the position they have or the company they work for. And they forget that that message that you just brought about the individual and how powerful that individual is. And I've seen people, as an example, you know, leave a company where they've had a big title and they've had that corner office, and all of a sudden feel like, you know, their worth has disappeared. because they don't have that corner office and they don't have their title. But the reality is, you know, that person up in that, you know, high rise, you know, office building, whether they're sitting at that chair looking at that view, yeah, or they're sweeping the floor on the street outside, it's the same human being, it's the same individual.
Yeah.
But their purpose shifts. And so what I'd like to do, if anybody's watching, if you have any questions for Joel with regards to RockstarX, please go and throw them in the comments and we'll share them on the screen as well.
I think that Don had actually commented again.
Well, I'm seeing a few over here. So let's have a look what, here we go. I think we're both clicking away there. So Don, what's this? So define what success means to you. Many people spend their lives trying to achieve success as defined, but that is gold dust, Don. It's so true. I'm starting to get, you know, a little glimpse of what the future holds with RockstarX, because every time I have a conversation with you, Joel, I don't have any expectations because I'm afraid that it adds a limitation.
Expectations add limitations. That's why I don't expect anything anymore. And if I want something, I go and do it myself. I mean, it's an old saying, if you want something, do it yourself. You don't wait for someone else to do it for you, because then it'll be their thing.
Absolutely. And it's quite an interesting thing, because my dad was a bit of an inventor. So he invented so many gadgets and all kinds of weird and wonderful things because he wanted to solve the problem. most of his gadgets, years later, I'd see them on some infomercial on television. And I'm like, Dad, why didn't you patent that? Why didn't you go and, you know, and he's like, now somebody else can go and use it. That's great. And I'm like, oh, man, crazy. So, you know, with this, you know, let's focus on RockstarX and the individual impact that you want to make for people, because this is quite a powerful message that you've brought about already through what we've spoken about, and that individual uniqueness that people need to embrace.
Yeah.
So tell me a bit more about, you know, what's your vision around the neurodiversity side of things? Like, what would you like to see that's different?
I like to see more communication. We harp on about awareness. We just had Autism Awareness Month. Fabulous. No. It should now be something different. You should now change. I've seen several people say this as well. I'm not the only one who says this. Even Quinn Dexter as well, of Autistomatic, has said, not on his videos, but he's said that it's now time for acceptance. It's not an awareness anymore. Awareness is kind of like street aware. I mean, it's like awareness is associated with something. Normally, it's associated with a life or death situation. Last time I checked, autism was neither of those things.
Absolutely. So what would you change? I mean, what would you change with regards to, obviously acceptance, as you've just said now. But what else would you like to see different? And then I'll go on to a couple of questions as well.
Thank you, Mike. Yes, it's a very interesting question. I would like to see more inclusivity. I mean, as we've talked about on this series so far, we've talked about the absolute horror show, which is the autistic employment, and
absolutely
people not giving anyone a chance. I mean, we're all human, unless you've got four legs and sniff on the ground or or like to play ball and chase things, you are a human. You're not a dog. You're not a cat. You're not something that is discarded, and don't even get me started on that, because we could open up a whole can of wormholes with third world countries in that particular realm. But I can't change people's minds. No one can. No human can. It's impossible. The only people that can change people's minds are the people that would be the minds to whom they belong to. I'm not here to change anyone's mind. I'm here to offer a solution and possibly a means of communication through another alternative, where we can all understand each other, and we can all understand each other through music and other creativeness and expressing ourselves. You take away expression, what do you got? You take away expression, you take away freedom of expression, you've got anything but a democracy.
So, I mean, expression is such an interesting thing, because I look at my brother as an example, who not only autistic, but he's also got Fragile X. And, this weekend, as an example, I did the crazy thing of letting him listen to Joel's playlist again. And my goodness me, did we have some fun around the house, because his expression is just this innocent joy. And I sing along to a song, but then they're singing along to a song. and he gets like, it's almost like the music is pumping through his veins, and it's like this energy that is just, I sit there and I look at it and I wish that I could tap into that. And it's like a drug of note that is something extremely difficult to tap into, but it's beautiful to see and watch. It's definitely something that needs to be understood, because a lot of people, as I'm sure you've experienced, when people are different, people tend to shy away, or I was having a conversation with my daughter a couple of days ago, and she was saying that because of the differences in the way she comes across with other people, people, instead of going, hey, why is this person different? What makes them tick? All of a sudden, the differences become the reason why people point fingers, and why people then start trying to look at it in a negative light of some sort. Instead of trying to understand it, criticize, and instead of trying to understand, and that's just such a strange human nature that we tend to have. So I'm conscious we have a certain amount of time, and I want to get through some of these questions as well. So
if needed, we can do a part two.
Well, I believe there'll be hundreds of parts as we go into the future. But I think that'll make an interesting topic of conversation around, why it's human nature it's almost like when we're faced with, some people, when they're faced with something that is like death, or something that's critical, or something that is frightening, that the only way to cope, or the coping mechanism that they use, is laughter and comedy and humor. And that's something that we've done, that's been around for many years, but it's, how do we turn that on its head so that people go, instead of going, you know, you're different, you're weird, you know, whatever the words are that come out, that they go, hey, you're different, can we find out more? Like, what's it about? Like, why are you so unique? And looking at how you get more out of that, because there's so much beautiful talent that has come out into the world where people have embraced the uniqueness. So let's put that other question up over here from Samuel. There we go. So Samuel asks, what's your greatest motivator that keeps you dedicated to achieving your goal?
There are many factors. That's a fantastic question, and there is no one answer. And it could take me several days, months, or even an entire lifetime to
tell. We have 13 minutes, by the way.
to tell all the reasons, but the most main one of all is that I've always wanted to become the company that I've always wanted to become my dream job, essentially. I could work for someone until the cows come home. I've done videoing, I've done social media, and I've done caretaking. I can work for other people until the cows come home, or I can create the job that I've always wanted to have, but never been given the opportunity to do. And the greatest motivators who do that are the people that have invented all the stuff we're using right now.
Absolutely. And I think I'm sure people that are watching this will agree with me that we have found a way to get the Joel magic out there, the opportunity of doing lives and interviews and just having conversations that really delve into these topics that most people avoid or don't have any knowledge on, because it's just not something that they have happening in their life on a daily basis. So, you know, opening up the world to the beauty that is neurodiversity is, I think, a conversation that will evolve to a stage where, instead of only having 22% of people with autism employed in any full-time job, to really having companies and organizations find a way to harness the magic that comes through that uniqueness. And this is the part that, you know, it's been, I guess, you know, in the world, most companies or organizations, it's like herding cattle because they want kind of the same things, you know, all the time coming through. And that's okay because that's, you know, the mass side of things. And that's, you know, delivering to the mass audience. But it's those individuals that make that journey so much more powerful and impactful. And this is where we need those ninja skills coming out, which take things to a whole new level. So you know, every time I speak to you, I mean, today, just those bombs that you dropped about being, and I've heard them said before, you know, about being the best version of yourself and all the rest of it. But when you put it into that perspective of just being, you know, a better drummer than yesterday, and when you compared that brother sister environment, and that's something that happens every single day in business. You know, I look at you know, why people sometimes don't succeed is because they're too focused on what everybody else is doing, and worried about the fear of missing out and everything else, instead of just cracking on and doing the and being their best version of themselves. And that's where the magic happens, whether it be on social media or anywhere. You know, when you find your magic, it's something that you need to embrace and run with. So what is the one thing that, from a RockstarX perspective, you would like to see, you know, in the next year or two? Like, what is the biggest impact that you would like to have had?
I like to have had to start to flip that. Well, it's currently the wrong 80-20 version. It's currently 20-80 to now to start flipping that to making sense again to 80-20. And giving more people like my students and the one who's on ASD and then like my cousin who's already made extraordinary strides with his band and a voice. It's taken society too long to accept the LGBTQ community.
I'm glad I didn't have to say that because I'm dyslexic.
The message that I want to give to society as well, obviously RockstarX to do this as well, is not to take so long to get to acceptance when you are already backed into a corner and you have no choice. The choice has to come from you. Don't be in a situation where you're forced to make this choice. Well, I'll tell you something, it's certainly more relaxing and less stressful if you are not forced to make a decision.
And I think that, you know, that acceptance is, you know, just allowing people to be, as opposed to sitting there and going, well, you're different from me, I can't accept this. You know, I mean, I get frustrated as hell. I mean, I have a massive, massive challenge in life when it comes to, you know, I walk down the high street and you know, people talk about, you know, religious issues, racism. They talk about, you know, neurodiverse challenges, all those things. I mean, my biggest challenge is I walk down the road and then I see somebody like you, Joel, with a great set of hair, you know, a great head of hair. And I just... I get like so annoyed because I mean, clearly, as you can see, I don't have that benefit. So I've had to drop it through the bottom of my face. you know, so, you know, we all have something that we kind of look at and go, it's different. You know, I've even done that. I've walked up to somebody and I went, I hate you. And they went, I beg your pardon. I said, your hair is incredible. And they were like, what? And you know, for me it was like the poor guy didn't quite know what to do with himself, but he really had good hair, and it's one of the things that I love doing is embracing those differences, you know, because yeah, it's what makes everybody so beautiful and so special and so you know unique, I guess is that weird word, but it's like if we were all the same, just imagine how boring this world would be, because you'd know exactly what they're going to do, what they're going to say, how they're going to respond. Yeah. And yeah, I mean, imagine the world full of a lot of bearded bald guys. It's just, I mean, it's just, it wouldn't be that, it's such a cool place.
I'd love to make an animated short about that and just see and literally have either someone like John Cleese or to get together with David Jason just arguing this I know what you're going to say. It's like it's going to be the 5 minute argument on Monty Python. It's
I know what you're talking about. Yeah. So, great, Joel. You know, I just love the energy that comes out when we start talking, because it's refreshing and revitalizing to know that you're not having those same conversations. And I look at sales as an example, you know, in the sales world, and you know, everybody's trying to beat everybody else and trying to do something, you know, manipulate their way through and get clients to buy their stuff, you know. And instead of trying to just be the best version of themselves, looking at the problem that they're trying to solve, you know, and this is one of the things I find magic, because every single one of us as humans are salespeople. And people, it's one of the things that, you know, people go, oh, sales, no, I'm not interested. But the reality is, we're all selling ourselves every single day. You know, whether it be to that service provider that is going to take on our business, or whether it be, you know, selling ourselves, you know, to our family members and getting them to accept or join or come for dinner, as an example. You got to sell that idea, because sometimes in the family, for some family members might go, I'll rather skip it because so-and-so is coming, or whatever the case may be, because there's always something that we have to try and bring their message across. So I think the beauty of RockstarX and where you are going with this, of inclusivity and really like accepting but also uplifting the individual differences, is something that's incredible. And you know, when it comes to those people that you are looking at trying to connect with right now, Joel, out there, you know, what kind of people are you looking at wanting to connect, to bring into your circle that can help you with a vision that is RockstarX?
Charities. So charities like Genius Within, the Garfield Western Foundation, even where your brother is, Kir Sharon, also venture capitalists as well, angels essentially, who can help get this from doing it through a 16-inch screen to finishing off a 3D print, which this has to be the longest 3D print I've ever seen.
So, you know, bringing it to reality and coming out there and face to face, and, you know, so one of the things that I wanted to point out, because Joel, we've been talking about, you know, and a lot of people have asked, like, so what is it that the RockstarX does? I thought I'd share a few of the conversations that we've had around some of the things and the visions that you would like to achieve and we'd like to see happen for you. So, you know, right now RockstarX is in that stage of putting together an incredible team, and we've got people that have commented already, you know, Samuel Baston, who's in the comments, and Joseph Storzinger, and we've got Robert Green and various other people that have got involved, and so many more in the background. But one of the things that we're looking at now is, you know, what are the solutions that RockstarX brings to the world? So things like putting together retreats or music retreats, and regardless of venue, I know we've got one in mind, but you know, putting retreats together for people with that are neurodiverse, where they can come out and they can have an opportunity to get involved in, you know, music, expressing themselves, learning how music can also help them cope with everyday day-to-day things. So if you know of organizations, or you know of charities that do this, or people that are involved in music therapy that would like to get involved, please reach out to Joel. We're also looking for people that are in the legal profession that can give guidance with regards to RockstarX and the future that is RockstarX, you know, when it comes to potentially having a charity side of the business, as well as the incorporation side of things as well, and the you know, the business side of things. So it's, you know, all those people that have a vision to have an impact when it comes to neurodiversity, you know, the people that want to see live events. And I'm you know, one of the things that I'm really keen on seeing for you, Joel, is doing a, you know, having a like a live concert where you've got you know, some of the big names bands there, but also people like the Autistics, you know, your cousin that you mentioned, you know, seeing you you know, on stage with you know, a collective band that is just made up you know, of people who want to express themselves, and you know, having people that can put that all together and raise awareness and funds for RockstarX and the wonderful things that you want to do in the future with regards to neurodiversity, and specifically in the autistic space as well. Is there anything else that you want to add to that, Joel?
I'm glad you didn't actually, Max, give an entire episode away on this one, because what RockstarX does is episode 6 or 7, and talk about it today, we will get up to episode 6 or 7 and then say, great, now what?
I never believe there'll be a now what with you, Joel. It's with the amount of ideas that you come up with, and the people that you're surrounding yourself with, I'm really excited about the journey that is RockstarX. So if you're watching this for the first time, or you haven't watched this before, you don't know who Joel is, you don't know what RockstarX is all about, hopefully we've you know, been as vague as possible so that it gives you an opportunity to kind of go, I've got to go and research this more and find out more, and let me reach out to Joel and find out what this means. Over to you.
I have also Max seen this and verified it. I put together a new introduction for all of RockstarX's branding now. And you will see this when we end the live, obviously. You will all see this, and I hope you like
it. So hang in till the end.
I hope you like it. And it was not there to give you information. It's only a 26-second sting, but we hope that it will get you more excited in the right way in the future as well.
I saw a comment over here, and I'm not and I'm actually going to give Naomi a shout out over here, because she's doing great things. But it says here, this is great, Joel and Mac, and you still look fabulous. So thank you. It's not every day that I hear that. So although watch the space, the beard's going blue due to a recent post I did, but more on that later. So watch the space. Excellent stuff. Well, listen, we've got to wrap up. Otherwise, we will be here all day, and we won't have to even wait for the next live, because we'll just you know, fold straight in. So, Joel, final words from you on RockstarX, and you know, what you want to say to those watching out there.
The earlier you get into this, the sweeter the perks.
Well, that's part of the long term journey, but
I mean, my students have already sort of seen some of this in real life recently, so Well, they're already in the door.
Excellent stuff. Well, let's make sure that we cover that when we talk about some of the things that RockstarX does, because that'll be pretty interesting. And at some stage, we'll be doing a live between Joel and I. So he doesn't know it yet, but I'm a live because I want to get to see Joel in action behind the drum kit and on that guitar. So hopefully we can do a live and maybe even get some requests in for Joel to play. That would be a bit of fun. So for those of you who have watched, I want to thank you very much for taking the time, for your comments, your love and attention, and your support. And do us a favor, make sure that you go onto LinkedIn and just search RockstarX and go and follow both the hashtag and the company page. Check out Joel's personal profile. But reach out, start a conversation and see where that may go. As my motto always goes, you never know where a conversation may lead. So thank you, everybody, for watching. And Joel, I look forward to for the next part of our mini series. And that'll be scheduled very soon as well, because Joel, as part of this mini series, is learning how to master LinkedIn. So watch the space. You're not getting rid of him. Excellent, folks. Listen, have a wonderful day and stay blessed.
See you then.
That was incredible. On that note, cheers, everybody. Have an incredible day.
See you then.